America, I'm back. Chef Tom, get a gourmet. So the room is starting to smell a little nutty. And we're gonna pull this out. Take a look at it. Okay. Not enough. Gonna take a little getting used to. What works best actually is a whisk. I thought we'd do a little YouTube and Queen tonight. Something's gone crazy. I had all these tags set up on my thing and now it's saying only a few and I can't figure it out. I went for a little while I was sitting and I can't do that. So I got up and decided I gotta do something else. But I want all this fried food stuff. Sometimes it's not always on paper or on time. I wrote this one paper to I took some sociology classes, and poetry is sociology, interesting, you know. I gotta get this fish out real quick. So, alright, rockfish, and I've never had rockfish fillet, so I'm really looking forward to keeping some of this and trying some of this in different ways. Alright. Just some more layers. There's one in there broken. I should get that one right. These are the full ones. The full glaze is some nice projects, right? Those look beautiful. I'll take that broken one too. Now we got some nice big fillets in here. Hold them gently up. Another thing, I reuse and reuse. I won't reuse this again. It's seafood. All right. Doing this quick, kind of. So right now, I'm deglazing. Getting the frozen, just the frozen off. That's like 70 degree water. That's perfect, right on touch. I'm just getting the frozen stuff off the outside. All right, and with fish, they'll stick together right away if you, and shrimp. All right, so I can push them. Just gotta push them. And then I drain that right away because that's full of sea brine and full of what they were packed with and freezer burn that's happened in the short time they've been in the freezer. So the sooner you get rid of that, and then you just put it into a cold water run, and bam. All right, so we're gonna use all this snapper. Why? Because, yeah. And I'm gonna do the same thing there. I'm gonna rinse that burn off. We're gonna keep this here. Guys, we're gonna make a stock. Where's my stock pot? Oh, that's my stock pot. Oh well. That's my stock pot. It's all gonna be together. Put that one there. Woo! Great idea. Mix it out. Wash it out. Yeah, so this just kind of jumps in my head. maybe this will make it so I can go sleep. I didn't run. I did a lot of cooking. And I actually have to wear my body out and then drink this coffee because I was at, I fall asleep trying to put load those videos. But I should be asleep. I find it, as long as I don't... Hey guys, you're way down there looking at my butt. Freaks. Somebody said that once or something. I don't even want to say it. Alright, so... add that in. Leave that in the water. This I'm going to break out. Yeah. We're going to skin and chunk that. I'm going to run water on that. I'm going to get the deglaze this Mahi Mahi. It's like the other stuff. I missed trash can. I didn't deglaze the sole because those things were so pressure packed so well. Alright. And so we're going to take... We're just going to do a regular, just base stock, and just, bam, shrimp, just like that. All right, those shrimp are getting old, so I just want to make a stock out of it, just like that. And, nothing special. All right, I'm just going to let that simmer for a while. Let's take a look at our flour. Woo! Now it's starting to cook. Look at that. It's hot. Shut the door. Second one down. I don't know where anything's at in my own kitchen now. I redid everything. I guess it, yeah. Whoops. All right, so it's starting to get like really, really brown, right? See? And then I'm gonna put it in there again. And let it bake another 7 minutes. Time 777 power zero start, and then the shrimp shells, we're gonna have that go for 30 minutes. Put running water on. Whoop, not hot. You want 70 degrees is like you're perfect. And I'm gonna pull the fish out as it's ready. I don't have to go hard water wild with the water I'm using. Shrimp for close. Mahi Mahi is going to take the longest in the snapper here. So, and you don't want the water actually hitting frozen fish because it'll dig a hole in it. So you want a free place to put the water. But the good movement is... necessary. This is necessary. It is necessary. Live feeds on. Live feeds on. So, the whole concept of a supernatural race that grew up under like a different star where they had gravity and sunlight and they had a blue star or something like that and they had electronic waves and that's how their whole cosmic energy flux, so on and so forth, was created. And they were one being. They never died. They came from one, as the silicone created into a massive body of cells of understanding, and then using the power of the sun. It's just a sci-fi thought I had, right? For my sci-fi stories. Using the power of the silicon energy, they learn to use the sun's power and gravity, and in a way, in a physical arena that we are totally unaware of, because they're next to gravitational forces, and they're using gravitational forces like you and I would use the sense of smell or the sense of sight. And just, you know, that's kind of a, like, wow. You know what I mean? Concept? And make sure I have that bag. I'm going to keep my shrimp bags tighter and smaller, I think. Well, my hands are... I need one right here, right? I put one on here. Like that. But then when I open the oven, it touches the floor. Don't like that. And always check when you're on your last bake, look ahead of time. Don't want to, I mean, I actually started burning this. But it's really, really nutty right now. And it's just going to be quite amazing. Yeah. So we're just doing another quick, this is a shrimp stock, or a, it's called fumé, little bay, so that's how I roll. And Ross said we're going to head towards Cajun already, and we're going to hit it with this Cajun seasoning. I love fusion cooking, as I said. These are fish flakes that James left me. And so I'm actually going to take some fish flakes and put it right in there with this to work up on my... Whew, boy, they're powerful. Man. Just going to put a little bit in. That's going to work with my fish flavor and bring all my fish flavor. This is going to be a real powerful stock I got here. We just put a big chunk of, like, what is that in there, all right? But this is like, you know, this is why we do this. All right. I'll taste it beforehand to know, you know what I mean? I ain't gonna make no wrong turns with a big batch. I'm over here with veggies. Spinach. Green onion, back red pepper. The two that are cut are out. There goes my stock. Felt it out of the corner of my ear. And then, all right, brought it to a boil. Now I bring it down to simmer. So I'm bringing down a simmer. Alright. And that's going to be my fish cross shrimp stock. Alright. Let that go gently for a little bit.